want to go over what I do for my rudimentary filing system and my numbers for 2018. What I do is I put all my receipts in a box, and I keep one in the truck and I keep one at home. I got one for 2019. And you can see it's a Walmart receipt, and I got storage box, $9.98, because I bought four more of these. So what I end up doing at the end of the year is I print out all my settlements, I print out all my credit cards, and then I go through them all, and then I take all the receipts, mostly out of the truck, and some of them at home. And then, you know, I put them in folders. I got repairs, of course. I have hotels. I have fuel, which is the biggest one. See, it's the thickest one. And then I have miscellaneous. So this all stays here. That goes there. That goes on a shelf in the closet. It stays in case I get audited. And that's my system. Like I said, I got one of these in the truck on my bed. And every time I get a fuel receipt, anytime I buy gloves, antifreeze, whatever, it goes in there. Oil changes, of course, all that stuff. So start of the year, or not start of the year, the end of the year, I did $178,349, right? I did 79,000 miles, and then I'll go through line by line. We got the 2290, that's $571. The base cost is $550, but you pay by credit card, the IRS charges you for the credit card, and then there's a handling fee, you know, another $10. Hotels was $2,593. Fuel, it's your biggest expense, $30,361. IFTA, that's $684. And then pre-pass is $4,000. And then pre-pass is also tolls, and there's like a weekly charge the company hits you with. And then you got tolls, and that's paper receipts, because pre-pass doesn't work for every toll. Permits were $385. Plates were $1,520. Qualcomm was $780. Truck insurance, $4,317. The shop, about $3,000 of that is tires. So it's $4,480. And then the interest for the truck note was $4,583. I got to add another $1,300 to that. I got two DOT physicals. The first one I did at like a MinuteClinic, and they refused to give me a piece of paper that the state of Jersey would accept. So I had to go to a cheaper place, and they did it, and they gave me the piece of paper I needed. Miscellaneous, $1,487. I got a storage locker because I used to be a flatbedder. So I got all my flatbed gear in there. Sirius XM, New Jersey DMV for getting the title of the truck. My car mileage that I use to move from Jersey down to the south. Repairs and oil changes is $9,300. The night's out, it's 234 plus 25 partial days. You gotta break that up between before October 1st and after October 1st. And that's gonna be about $12,400-ish. Depreciation is $27,500. The first year I only took $7,000 in depreciation. Because I wanted to raise my income level so I can buy a house or something. My phone bill is $1,688. So I got this year, meaning 2019, I can depreciate another $27,500, and then I'm done. So student loan interest is $915. I'm not sure how it's going to work with the new tax law. So when it's all said and done, after including depreciation, I cleared $66,921, and I worked about 9 months. Now, that's about $15,000 worth of taxes I'm going to have to pay. So I'm going to have to file an S-Corp. And after I file the S-Corp, and then, well, I guess you create an LLC, and then you file an S-Corp declaration. And then I could pay myself a salary, and then I could reduce my overall burden for the FICA, because you've got to pay the 15, I think it's 15.3. So, like, if my marginal tax rate is 22%, and then I'm paying 15.3, and then I got to pay Jersey tax. So every dollar I make, I'm paying like 40-some, you know, cents on the dollar, which is bad. And then you turn around and then you go, well, I can get rid of the 15, and I guess I can move to a state like Texas and get rid of the, you know, the state income tax. But we'll have to see how it plays out. Well, that's my year cap. I mean, what I worry about or wonder about is like 2 years from now when I don't have depreciation value, and then I clear $100,000, and then I got to pay taxes on $100,000. That's gonna be a heavy hit. And then you're gonna start looking for how do you shelter the money? I mean, you could put money in a 401k, and that'll protect you. You know, that will. But I think the limit's only like $5,000 or $6,000 a year you could put in. All right. Have a good day.